Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Thursday of the 33rd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord said, I think thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me and I will answer you, and I will lead back your captives from every place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you. For it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Maccabees. The officers of the king in charge of enforcing the apostasy came to the city of Modin to organize the sacrifices. Many of Israel joined them, but Mattathias and his sons gathered in a group apart. Then the officers of the king addressed Mattathias. You are a leader, an honorable and great man in this city, supported by sons and kin. Come now, be the first to obey the king's command, as all the Gentiles and the men of Judah and those who are left in Jerusalem have done. Then you and your sons shall be numbered among the king's friends, and shall be enriched with silver and gold and many gifts. But Mattathias answered in a loud voice, although all the Gentiles in the king's realm obey him, so that each forsakes the religion of his fathers and consents to the king's orders, yet I and my sons and my kin will keep to the covenant of our fathers. God forbid that we should forsake the law and the commandments. We will not obey the words of the king, nor depart from our religion in the slightest degree. As he finished saying these words, a certain Jew came forward in the sight of all to offer sacrifice on the altar in Modin, according to the king's order. When Mattathias saw him, he was filled with zeal. His heart was moved, and his just fury was aroused. He sprang forward and killed him upon the altar. At the same time, he also killed the messenger of the king who was forcing them to sacrifice, and he tore down the altar. Thus he showed his zeal for the law, just as Phinehas did with Zimri, son of Salu. Then Mattathias went through the city shouting, let everyone who is zealous for the law and who stands by the covenant follow after me. Thereupon he fled to the mountains with his sons, leaving behind in the city all their possessions. Many who sought to live according to righteousness and religious custom went out into the desert to settle there. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
God the Lord has spoken and summoned the earth, from the rising of the sun to its setting. From Zion, perfect in beauty, God shines forth.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Gather my faithful ones before me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. And the heavens proclaim his justice, for God himself is the judge.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Offer to God praise as your sacrifice, and fulfill your vows to the Most High. Then call upon me in time of distress. I will rescue you, and you shall glorify me.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Alleluia, alleluia. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus drew near Jerusalem, he saw the city and wept over it, saying, "If this day you only knew what makes for peace, but now it is hidden from your eyes. For the days are coming upon you when your enemies will raise a palisade against you. They will encircle you and hem you in on all sides. They will smash you to the ground and your children within you, and they will not leave one stone upon another and within you because you did not recognize the time of your visitation." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, this is a very dramatic scene, actually. No, I've never been to the Holy Land yet. No, hopefully I will be able to make a pilgrimage. No, but according to the description of the commentaries of the scholars, no, the Lord was coming down from the mount from the Mount of Olives. No, and they say that there's a magnificent view of Jerusalem, no, coming down from the Mount of Olives. And this is the scene, ano. Ito kumbaga ito yung setting, ano, ng ebanghelyo to. Ang Panginoon ay nandoon na nga doon sa lugar na yon, sa kung saan meron siyang napakagandang view, no, napakagandang vista ng city of Jerusalem, no. And you could see the emotion now of the Lord, no, because of two things. Number one, he was going to Jerusalem knowing that was where he was going to suffer, no? He'll go through his passion and then he will be put to death on the cross, no? But his bigger lament was that when he wept over Jerusalem was that they will suffer a real destruction. Diba? Remember, I think 70 AD, Jerusalem will be destroyed, no? It will be totally taken over and destroyed, no? by conquerors. And that is because of the political ambitions going on within Jerusalem. Nag-aaway-away sila, no? So maraming masasabi natin na ano, intriga, maraming political na labanan, no? Kaya yun yung iniyak ng Panginoon. Because they did not listen to the message that he was bringing, no? Which is the message of salvation, the way of the cross, but the way to salvation. In fact, Jerusalem itself would reject him and would bring about his suffering and death, no? So siguro yun yung unang puntong dapat natin mapagnilayan, ano? Na ito ang bigat na dala ng Panginoon, no? Yung main point na nais kong pagnilayan natin ngayon, no, is yung katapusan ng ebanghelyo ngayong araw. Matapos niyang ibigyan ng description, 'di ba, kung paano masisira ang Jerusalem. This is actually going to happen, no? But the end of it, of the gospel, says that they will not leave one stone upon another within you. You will be totally destroyed. Mawawara kayo, masisira kayo. And this is the beautiful line. Because you did not recognize the time of your visitation. And siguro yun ang hilingin natin, yun ang pagdasalan natin. Ano ba yung mga panahon na dumalaw sa atin ang Panginoon? Nanahan ang Panginoon sa atin at binibigyan tayo ng babala, ano? Binibigyan tayo ng guidance, di ba? Na kailangan, we must overcome all of the division, all of the evil, all of the corruption, all of the political maneuverings, all of the, really, no, the corruption and the lust and quest for power na sa katapusan maraming nagdurusa ng mga mahihirap, no? Marami ang walang pagkain, walang trabaho, and we did not recognize the time of our visitation. And I guess that is something that we must seriously reflect on and pray for. Hilingin natin ang biyaya na itong mga darating na buwan kilatisin natin saan ba tayo tinatawag ng Diyos. Ano ba ang sinasabi sa atin ng Diyos? Ano ba ang sinasabi sa atin ng ating tunay na pananampalataya sa Panginoong Hesukristo? At saan niya tayo binibigyan ng liwanag at binibigyan ng gabay? Mahalaga yan kasi ang ating gagawin itong mga darating na buwan ay pwedeng maging isang magandang kinabukasan at magandang darating na mga 6 na taon para sa ating bayan. At hilingin lang natin, ang hinihingi ko lang sa atin lahat, ay hilingin natin ang biyaya ng pangingilatis, discernment. Discernment in order to recognize the time of our visitation, where God is leading us to. Remember, that's what I always tell you about prayer. Pray as if everything depended on us, and work as if everything depended on God. Because in our prayer of discernment, we will recognize the times of our visitation. Maaaninagan natin ang presensya ng Espiritu ng Diyos at ang paggabay ng Espiritu. At pag nakita natin yun, buong puso natin, buong diwa natin, italaga ang ating sarili sa paggawa ng gawa ng Diyos. Let us pray that we may be given that grace in the coming months. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us make our prayers of intercession as part of our pilgrimage of faith, following Christ to that eternal Jerusalem, our promised inheritance. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may become a living sign and instrument of unity and peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as a community of believers, we may not be divided by petty barriers of hatred and prejudice, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may avoid making excuses in responding to the demands of our faith, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we also pray for all the souls of the faithful departed, the souls in purgatory, that we are also asked to pray for in our Masses during this month of November. For all of these we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together, dasalin natin ang panalangin para sa halalan 2022. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa halalang 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayan sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoon Jesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na uunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami. Lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina, higit sa anumang interes sa pansarili o para sa grupo. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maghahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit. Banal na Espiritu, tanglawa ng aming mga isip at puso, nang aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangangailangan ng aming mga kapwa Pilipino at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakayahang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ng tama ang mga pinuno na tunay na mamumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung anong higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa oras na ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Imaculada Concepcion, patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Bye. by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Ernesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. We pray most specially for all the souls commended to our prayers during this month of November. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through Him, with Him, and in Him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oration.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear. May they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love, for and service to one another. Guide our experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of Him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless all of us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming salamat po. Thank you for joining us. And have a good day ahead. Thank you.
Purihin ang Diyos at magpasalamat tayo sa Kanya. Ipapatupad na po natin ang ating Ale Kapwa Legacy Program ng Caritas Pilipinas, Pamilya Feeding Program at Educational Assistance Program para sa ating mga kabataan. 6 na mga dioceses ang tatanggap ng tulong para sa Pamilya Feeding Program. Ang dioceses ng Kidapawan, Cotabato, Capiz, Dumaguete, Infanta, at Libmanan. Bawat pamilya po ay bibigyan natin ng 300 pesos every day. At ang bawat diocese ay pipiliin natin ang mga beneficiaries, 60 families for every dioceses. At itong tulong ay ibibigay natin for 6 months. Para naman sa ating Educational Assistance Program, 10 mga dioceses ang bibigyan natin ng tulong. Ang dioceses ng Buntok, Basilan, Hulo, Marawi, Libmanan, Infanta, Dumaguete, Capiz, Cotabato, at Kidapawan. Bawat diocese po ay pipili ng 50 na mga kabataan. At ang bawat bata na ating tutulungan ay bibigyan natin ng 10,000 pesos. At maliban dyan, ay tutulungan pa natin na magkaroon sila ng mga gadgets para sa kanilang pag-aaral. Ang lahat po nito ay ating ginagawa upang ang ating mga kababayan ay maiangat natin sa kanilang paghihirap at mabigyan natin ng magandang kinabukasan ang ating mga kabataan. Tulungan niyo po ang Caritas Pilipinas. Magtulungan po tayo para sa ating bayan. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.